let's learn how React works. Before we continue, make sure React is loaded on your page. Now let's create our first React element. Type react.createElement and pass the string p. What you'll notice is an object is returned. But wait, shouldn't a DOM element return? Well, React doesn't actually create DOM elements. It creates React elements, which are objects that describe how elements should render. In this case, the type is a paragraph tag. And what if you want to give our React element some text? We can pass it in the third parameter. Now, when you open up props, you'll find text as a value of children. So, if React is agnostic of the DOM, then how do we actually render elements to the page? That's where ReactDOM comes in. With ReactDOM.render, we pass in the React element as the first argument, and the DOM node as a second. Now, the element is actually rendered. You can also confirm this in the Elements panel as well. As you can tell by the data attribute, the topmost React element is also known as the root element. So how do we style our React element? To style our React element, we can pass in a style object in the second parameter. Here, I'm going to set the text color to tomato. You should immediately notice that the style is inlined. Then I'm going to set the font size to 24 pixels. If the camel casing throws you off, just remember that we're using JavaScript to style the element. This means we need to be aware of the differences between the DOM API and CSS. There are some element attributes that are named or capitalized differently so not to conflict with the native API or language. To set the element's class, we'll need to use class name so not to conflict with the JavaScript reserve word class. And adding events like onClick should be straightforward as well. React's synthetic event system will register your event correctly across different browsers. If you click the DOM event, an alert is triggered. Finally, if you want to add more text or React elements, you can continue to pass them in the third or following parameters. You can see that a React element is rendered in between the text. You can nest React elements as deeply as you want, but there's always a single root element at the beginning. So to recap everything, React elements declaratively describes how the UI looks. For React.createElements, the first argument is the type, which can be a string or a function. The second argument is the props, which are the HTML attributes and custom properties. Any additional arguments are the children, which are the React nodes like text and React elements. Finally, use ReactDOM to render a React element to the page.